morning, Toastmasters and guests. Good afternoon, Toastmasters and guests. Today, I'll be narrating a story which was part of my fifth grade English literature. It's a story called James and the Giant Peach by Roald Dahl. I'm not sure how many of you have read it, but I'll be following this story by the simple takeaways which we can apply with into our lives and what I particularly like about this story. So, here's how the story goes. There's a small boy who is 4 years old. His name is James Harry Trotter, and he lived with his parents by the sea. One day, a rhinoceros comes from the woods and eats his parents, so he's orphaned. Yeah, don't give me that expression, it gets crazier along the way. So yeah, after the rhinoceros eats his parents, he's orphaned and he's forced to live with his aunts Spiker and Sponge. They were very abusive and they used to treat him very badly. They used to give him stale food, they used to make him sleep on the floor and whatnot. What happens is, one day after an argument with his aunts, he just walks out of the house and he just sits under a tree sobbing, and he finds a mysterious wizard who comes to him, an old man. This old man, he hands James some crystals or green beans, whatever you like to call. He says, if you drink this potion, if you make a potion out of this and drink it, your life will be filled with adventures. What happens is, on his way back, he stumbles upon something and he drops the crystals on a nearby peach tree. The next morning, when he wakes up, he sees that that peach tree has one giant peach, which is as big as his house. That's when they were absolutely happy, the evil aunts, and they try to commercialize this whole situation. What they do is, they sell tickets to tourists and they try to encash the money. And James was just allowed to see the peach from his window, and he could just go and clean up after all the tourists had left. He, one day during his regular cleanup sessions, he had seen that there's a small tunnel which led him into the peach. He went into the peach through the narrow aperture, only to realize that there were seven different creatures inside the peach. A centipede, a spider, a silkworm, a glowworm, a ladybird. What else? Think of other insects, but yeah, two more insects. Okay, so at first when he saw these insects, he was like, oh my god, and he was very scared. But sooner or later, he made friends with them over the night, and the next morning, the centipede helped eat the stem of the peach, and the peach rolled over its aunts and killed them, and it rolled into the sea. So, yeah, it rolled into the sea, and that's when his whole journey of adventure started. Once the peach rolled into the sea, with the help of the silkworm and spider, they had made threads, and they used the earthworm as a bait to attract 500 seagulls. Once they attracted the seagulls, they tied the threads to the neck of the seagulls, and as the seagulls flew, the peach started flying with them. They reached the higher part of the sky, and the centipede was very arrogant and rude, and it mocked the cloud demons. The cloud demons got angry at the whole situation, and they started throwing hailstones at the peach. James tried to maneuver this whole situation and somehow brought the peach to a lower part of the sky. And that's when they realized they are in New York. So yes, people of New York thought that it was a bomb or it was a threat to the city, and what they did is they alerted the emergency services. After the peach had completely descended, that's when they realized that, oh, it's just a peach and it's not any threat. At that point of time, James told this story to all his to all the kids in New York, and he made a lot of friends. So yes, that's the story. That's how it ended. So as a kid, I'm like, wow, if he can stay in a giant peach, I want to stay in a giant sitaphal. Just imagine how many rooms it will have. Unlimited food forever. But now I'm just like, what was that? What sort of a story is that? So yeah. That's what happens. But going back to it, there are some very simple lessons which we can learn from it, and probably we should make use of it in our day-to-day lives. One is to be independent. If James had never taken that step into the peach, if he had never thought about himself and adventuring into the peach, this whole thing would have never started. His life of adventure would have never begun. So it is always important that you take a stand for yourself, and you take that that one step because you never know what the future holds for you. The second thing, it's never too late to give up on friendship. Regardless of his past with his parents and his abusive aunts, and the fact that he was very scared of the insects in the peach, he still went ahead and he didn't judge them by the way they looked, but instead went ahead and made friends with them. And it all turned out for the good. He had a very adventurous journey and now he has a story to share and he has made a lot of friends in New York and he's very happy about it. Apart from these things, one thing which really stuck with me is the fact that imagination is very important. Who would have ever thought that you would find seven creatures in a giant peach, make friends with them, and your life would be filled with adventures? Who would have ever thought that angering the cloud demons would make them throw hailstones at your peach? Who would have ever thought that a story as crazy as this will be incorporated into English literature? So I would like to end by saying one thing. Imagination is key. Everything that is reality today was once someone's imagination. Thank you.